The Antonio Project present Procedure of Hydrostatic Pressure Test for Bunker Pipeline.
Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. At this time, I would like to share to you about how to conduct hydrostatic pressure test for bunker pipeline. In accordance to Siri 2.0, a vessel's bunker transfer system should be tested to 100% of the rated working pressure, sometimes referred to as maximum allowable working pressure or MAWP, at least annually. Oil transfer system should be tested to 1.5 times of their rated working pressure or MAWP at least twice within any 5 years period. Pressure testing should be a hydrostatic test. Pressure testing using compressed air or inert gas is not acceptable. Please take note that this video is just for reference and study. Hydrostatic pressure test is hazardous activity. Wear proper PPE, put marking on the testing area for personal safety, and don't forget to install all scupper plug to prevent oil pollution. And then, how to conduct hydrostatic pressure test? Let's check out my animation.
Description: hydrostatic pressure test is a way in which pressure vessels such as pipelines, plumbing, gas cylinders, boilers, and fuel tanks can be tested for strength and leak. The test involves by completely filling the component with liquid and pressurization of the vessel with the specified test pressure. Normally, the pressure test is to be carried out with 1.5 times of its MAWP. Maximum allowable working pressure or MAWP is the maximum pressure at which the weakest point of the equipment, system or a vessel can handle at a specific temperature when in normal operation. Design pressure, the maximum pressure that the system that can be exposed to, and set the system relief valve at the same pressure. Relief pressure, typically in pressure relief valve, PRV, PSP, a preset pressure to protect or control a pressurized system or component during an overpressure event, from instrument or equipment failure or fire. Equipment involved with hydrostatic bunker pipe pressure test. At the bunker manifold, there are pressure gauge, pressure transmitter, butterfly valve 10 kilo 200A, pipe STBG370 schedule 80, design working pressure 4 bar, maximum allowable working pressure is 4.4 bar. Flanges 10 kilo 200A. Normally, MAWP or maximum allowable working pressure stated on the piping diagram as above picture. But where ships drawing do not define the MAWP for the bunker pipeline system, the MAWP may be assumed to be either the pressure relief valve is set, or where no relief valves are fitted, the maximum discharge pressure including hydraulic shock that can be developed by the vessel pump. Dresser type expansion joint 10 kilo 200A. Safety valve, setting pressure 4.4 bar. Sounding pipe. Air fan. Save all. MGO storage tank port side, manhole, level transmitter, drain valve, fuel or MGO transfer pump, maximum discharging pressure is 3.5 bar. MGO storage tank starboard side, equipment needed for hydrostatic bunker pipe pressure test, air hose, drums filled with MGO or fuel, pneumatic pump. This pump usually used for painting purpose. It can build up pressure up to 210 bar. Therefore, this pneumatic pump is suitable for hydrostatic pressure test. High pressure hose for connecting pneumatic pump and bunker pipeline. Bucket for collecting draining fuel during air purge. Calibrated pressure gauge to indicate hydrostatic pressure. Spanner for connecting hydrostatic pressure equipment. Bunker pipe connection flange to high pressure hose. Connection of hydrostatic pressure test equipment. Connect air hose to compressed air valve and to pneumatic pump inlet air regulator valve. Adjust inlet air pressure to 7 bar if necessary. Connect high pressure hose to pneumatic pump. Next, line up suction hose from pneumatic pump to MGO drums. At least, it is require about 500 liter of MGO for pressurizing bunker pipeline to 6.6 bar. It is depend into length, size of pipe and target pressure. Connect high pressure hose to bunker hydrostatic flange. Line up bunker piping line. Next is line up bunker line for hydrostatic pressure test. Close GOV06 MGO storage filling valve port side. Open GOV05 MGO transfer pump intermediate valve. Open GOV04 MGO transfer pump suction valve and GOV03 MGO transfer pump delivery valve. Open GOV01 MGO storage tank starboard side outlet valve. Install jack-up bolt to safety valve cover. If jack-up bolt is not available, use steel bar to jack up safety valve. Close GOV07 MGO straight tank starboard filling valve. Close GOV08 MGO bunker manifold keep valve. Install all deck scuppers. It is to prevent any oil leakage to discharge to overboard. Bunker pipeline air purge using MGO transfer pump. After line up bunker line completed, then continue to fill bunker pipeline with MGO and purge all air inside pipeline. At this time, suction of transfer pump using MGO storage tank starboard side. Start MGO transfer pump and watch carefully discharging pressure. Since only drain valve at manifold being open, pressure will build up rapidly. At the same time, during filling bunker pipeline, carry out air purge to remove all air inside of the pipe. Watch carefully the condition of purging air. During filling MGO to the bunker pipeline, start and stopping of MGO transfer pump will be carried out several times. It is in order to prevent pump overpressure. As per the design, the maximum pressure of transfer pump is 3.5 bar. MGO transfer pump is a positive displacement type. It will be stopped when pressure is reached about 4 bar, as it should not permit backflow. Carefully check drain condition of air purging. When confirmed that all air inside of bunker piping escape and MGO continuously flowing from drain pump, close drain valve and stop MGO transfer pump. Carefully monitor discharging pressure and also regularly check joints, flanges, dresser, etc. from any leakage. Allocate enough personnel to carry out regular patrol during filling bunker pipeline. Soon, after stopping MGO transfer pump, close GOV-05 MGO transfer pump intermediate valve in order to isolate the pressure on the bunker piping line. Check bunker manifold pressure and drain line. Currently, bunker manifold pressure is 2 bar on the analog pressure gauge and 1.98 on the digital pressure transmitter. Pressurizing bunker pipeline using pneumatic pump. After completion of air purging and filling MGO to bunker pipeline, next step is increase the pressure as per the target, 1.5 times from MAWP or maximum allowable working pressure, 4.4 bar times 1.5 equal to 6.6 bar. When confirmed that pressure is steady after isolating drain valve, then we can proceed to next step. Increasing pressure by pneumatic pump to the target pressure, 6.6 bar. Open miniature valve of high pressure hose to bunker pipe connection flange. Then, air purge of high pressure hose and pneumatic pump. Close drain valve when found MGO came out from drain pipe. Open compressed air service line valve. Then, confirm that inlet pressure is about 7 bar. If necessary, adjust the pressure regulator. Open air inlet valve to pneumatic pump slowly and check any leakage on the high pressure hose. When found all connection is under normal condition, then continue to pressurize bunker pipeline. Regularly check MGO level on the drum for pressurizing bunker line. If found under low level, shift suction hose to next standby drum. Carry out regular patrol during pressurizing bunker pipeline. Make sure that connection, joints, flanges, dresser, pressure gate, etc. is under normal condition and no leakage is found. Following items are necessary to be checked. Pneumatic pump hose connection. Valves and safety valve. Pressure type expansion joint. Flanges. Bunker manifold drains, pressure gauge set, transmitter. After confirm that all piping line is clear from leakage and pressure is reaching to 6.6 bar, then close inlet supply air to pneumatic pump. Next, close miniature valve of the bunker pipeline flange. Confirm that pressure on the bunker line is steady at 6.6 bar after isolation of the miniature valve from pneumatic pump. Then with the pressure for over than 10 minutes. Hydrostatic test pressure holding time. The hydrostatic test pressure must be maintained for a minimum total time of 10 minutes. And for such additional time as may be necessary to conduct the examination for leakage required by Code of Federal Regulation, Subchapter 56.97-30. When confirmed that pressure is steady at 6.6 bar, It means that the bunker line is considered under normal condition, no leakage, and it is in accordance to the regulation. Bunker pipeline pressure test on site.
Today we will conduct the hydrostatic pressure test for FO bunker line.
Safety valve check-up using steel bar. Filling and purging step of bunker pipeline using MGO transfer pump. Pressurizing step of bunker pipeline using pneumatic pump after completion of air purging and MGO filling to bunker pipeline. Ground check of bunker piping line. Confirmation of bunker line pressure on the manifold. After completion of hydrostatic pressure test, slightly open MGO straight tank filling valve to release pressure. Next, remove check-up bolt from safety valve cover. Then, secure compressed airline and other tools. Thank you for watching my video. If you think that my video is useful, please click like and subscribe button. Your subscription is fuel for my channel engine to stay running. Sharing knowledge is the simplest way to give charity. Therefore, please click share for others. Appreciate for your subscription. See you in my another video. Bye-bye. The Antonio Project.